professional friends, in this video I am going to discuss about how to register your NGO, trust or section 8 company online under FCRA, or to take prior permission in certain cases, or to renew the existing NGO, trust or section 8 companies under FCRA. For seeking FCRA services, registration, prior permission and renewal, the applicant must make it online through NITI Aayog website. He has to obtain DARPAN ID from DARPAN portal of NITI Aayog. Then he has to upload documents electronically online. So for getting FCA registration, you have to upload all the documents electronically online, pay application fee electronically online, have a definite cultural, economic, education, religious or social program. You should have a common program, acceptable program, have undertaken reasonable activity of charity in its chosen field for the benefit of the society for which the foreign contribution is proposed to be utilized. Open a dedicated foreign contribution bank account. This is very important. As per amendment 2020, every NGO, every section 8 company, every trust, has charitable trust, has to open a dedicated foreign contribution bank account in State Bank of India, Parliament Street Branch, New Delhi, and all the foreign contributions should come through that account only. Intimate opening of additional dedicated foreign contribution utilized bank account. So if the existing FCR trust or section 8 company can use the existing bank account as additional dedicated foreign contribution account and need not close it. Place the audited balance sheet electronically online on receipts and utilization of foreign contribution, including income and expenditure statement, receipt and payment of account and balance sheet for every financial year beginning on the first day of April within 9 months of the closure of the financial year. So from the closure of the financial year, the every trust, NGO or section 8 company should place the annual accounts online. In case of receipt of which receives the funds from the foreign, maintain a separate set of accounts and records exclusively for the foreign contribution received and utilized and for which the registration is. So you have to, the NGO has to maintain two separate accounts book, one for receipt of foreign contribution and one for utilization of the foreign contribution amount. Apply to the central government 6 months before the date of the expiry certificate of registration for it. So your renewal is, your registration is going to expire, then you should not go to the government on the last hour. You should apply for renewal well before 6 months before the expiry. So you should be very careful to renew your registration and make the application before 6 months to intimate any change in the designated bank account, utilization bank account, name, address, aims, objectives, key members in respect of association granted registration, prior permission under FCRA 20. So you have to intimate through online all these changes in a designated bank and everything. Then next, very frequently asked question is, when the dedicated bank account of NGO, trust or section 8 company of SPA parliament branch is to be opened. When one of the query is, if the NGOs can receive funds in the present FCR designated account, let us call it existing designated account, from a foreign donor, answer is unequivocally yes. You can receive the funds up to 31st March 2021 from your existing bank account, every trust and charitable trust. But after 31st March only you have to receive from the designated bank branch of State Bank of India Parliament branch. Government realized that it may take time to open a bank account, and so if no time slot is given, the whole sector would come to a standstill, since it would take time for the thousands of NGOs to open bank account in SBI Parliament Street on or before 31st March 2021. Receipt of foreign funds only through SBI Parliament Street branch, New Delhi. Till the time bank account is open, NGOs can receive funds in their existing designated account. However, the day designated account is opened in the SBI Parliament Street, New Delhi, from that day onwards, no funds can be received in existing designated bank account. Also, please note that the last day being the 31st March 2021, all must open the bank account in SBI Parliament Street branch before 31st March 2021. Whether one has to transfer the funds lying in the existing bank account of NGO or trust to the dedicated branch, SBI branch account, New Delhi, no. The money lying in the present account should remain there and can be utilized from there itself. Section 17(1) of the FCRA, second para, clearly states that another bank account can be opened wherever NGO wants to keep the utilize the funds. Thus, money lying in your earlier designated bank account need not be transferred to SBI Parliament Street branch in New Delhi. In any other case, money to be received in SBI Parliament should be only for the purpose of remittance of foreign currency. So, any funds received from the foreign, that has to be received only from the SBI Parliament Street branch. SBI Parliament Street branch is not likely to accept any funds which are not coming from outside it. This is very important announcement. So friends, I think this will be more useful for you because of the recent amendments in FCRA 2020. So these rules and regulations will come into effect immediately, and opening a bank account in dedicated bank account in the Parliament Street, New Delhi, is to be open on or before 31st March 2021. Friends, if you like this video, I request you to subscribe my channel. Thanking you once again, R.V. Shekhar, Practicing Company Secretary.